He's fired early. Work out how gripping that ash is. We want to send him anyway.
Fastest tracks these guys have done.
I'd like to say I'm not angry with myself, I am.
I want to enjoy, I want your plan, I want to buy the door. G Wagon. Oh, the bim.
No, I don't see many of these.
Guys, so I just got this band from an anime character. It's not too bad.
Thank you. is just about a mile long, specifically now.
Granddad had to go in one of these, I think.
No, like, days, I think.
On your credit card. But maybe you don't have your tire pressures correct, right? Like, tire pressures are such an incredibly powerful tool for setting up the handling of your car. Like, it's a pretty basic thing, but until you put those basics set up correctly, the other parts are never going to be able to work to their full potential. And so a lot of the tweaks that you will see to get the balance of the car just right, you're going to see a lot of cars coming into the pits to adjust their tire pressures, because you can adjust your grip levels, you can even adjust your you know, side to side roll to a degree, like the sponge stiffness. Oh, we have a car off on turn one, had a kill. We've got a Civic in the gravel, manages to keep it going, so we have a flashing yellow there at Paddock Hill. Can't quite see who that is. That's one of the Civics who I presume is doing some practice for the Racing Monsters Championship a little bit later on. So that all seems to be pretty good. So it's as such. Paddock Hill, of course, a very tricky corner. It's off camber, downhill, around a blind corner. It's a very tricky one. And then you have that gravel on the outside. So if you do run a little bit wide, you're in trouble. So Paddock Hill, a real challenge. One of the reasons why driving this particular track intimidates me so much, it's literally Paddock Hill. Paddock Hill is like a horrifying, fire-breathing dragon of a corner. It's terrifying. It's like a roller coaster. It is like a roller coaster. That's sector one, where you fly down Paddock Hill and then up and in the Druids and then back down the hill into Graham Hill. That's sector incredible. But yeah, and of course, tire pressure is very much linked to your tire temperature. And as your tires warm up, which tires need to do, they need to get nice and hot and soft and gummy. You know, if you've ever seen, you know, not that I would ever recommend doing this, but if you put some plastic or rubber over a flame, you'll see it will immediately soften and melt. But it initially goes to that phase of softening, right? So when it's nice and warm and hot, it gets soft and sticky and gummy. And that's when tires bite into the road at their best. But when they're hot, the air inside gets hot, and the hot air expands, and your tire pressures change. So, you know, you will set your tire pressures when they're cold, because the car is parked up. And then you'll get the temperature, the tire pressure will change, and then you might need to change your tire pressures, because they've now changed, because the temperature's changed. So, again, you know, getting on top of this relationship is really key as well. And that's probably one of the, you know, if you watch the pits,
Might have had some retirements from practicing there this morning, some issues. I think Ryan Hughes is having a diff issue, maybe. Don't know if he's out, don't know if the guys have changed. We're going to find out. But yeah, if you guys want to keep an eye on the At Drift Pro Championship social media channels, you see some nice images as we get away from the track, along with our qualification order and our battle tree as we get into that later on in the day. As always, our head judge, Maz Mani here, Julian Smith, Tyler Kelly up at the tower. So our first driver will be Ryan Hughes, the DY Engine Services GTA 6. The 2JZ powered GTA 6 runs 1,070 brake horsepower. 1,070, that number grows every time, doesn't it? It's a colder day, so we get 70 today. So very, very fast, very sexy GTA 6. New coming to us this year, absolutely making himself known. So first up the line, car number 20, Ryan Hughes. Once again, I want to thank our sponsors, Bosner, Lucas Oil, Tegawa, eBay, Ken Models, Bill Steen, Fifth Gear Transport, Scott Harnesses, GFB, Geologists. Oh, unfortunately, Ryan Hughes not leaving the line. It'll be Joel Conlon, a new driver for this year, missing out on summing of the run. With engine failure in the first run, so I'm back in. You can hear those cars warming up the tires at the top there. Coming down the line now, mixed weight transfer initiated. Very fast through, shallow through the first zone, mixed weight on the top. This track very steep as you get further up the line. Mixed weight at the top, not an awful lot of smoke, but still getting around. And down across the line, tiny little run there for Joe. Believe it or not, it's one of the lower powered cars in the grid. Only 480 brake horsepower compared to the average of 800-ish, 700-ish for the other cars. Still getting himself running very, very fast. Colour Sound Experiment JZX100, it's an LSXR supercharged engine, 1,007 brake horsepower. Here it comes, Colour Sound Experiment. Wide and across the line, tiny, tiny run for Hayden. This car definitely suiting this track, big power, big grip. Just getting used, if you notice that big flash of things falling off the JZX100 there, it was this driver car to be left in the boot. All the driver cars sat on the boot, coming off like confetti. Next up, Paul Beachy, the Peacock Performance R34 four-door, powered by a 2JZ. Here he comes. Beachy, the fast flick in. Keep it on the power. Good angle start line so far. Makes its way up top of the hill. Absolutely gets back onto it. It's a great run so far for Beachy. Massive improvement. Great run so far. And across the lines, everyone likes to see that. Then, LS3 powered supercharged, 300Z33 350Z. Here it comes. Bit of a wave at the top, gets itself back on, turns on the smoke, and pushes down and through and across the line. BC Racing S15, powered by 2JZ. 800 brake horsepower rescue, here it comes. Very, very capable driver. Fast flick in. Out to the wide line. Good angle for the center section. Line up on the limiter. new speed to top the track. Back onto the podium, absolutely smoking it out. Right to the edge of the track. Great run from Oliver Evans. Next up, Jordan Smith, the IA Motorsport Nervous Finance Mazda MX-5, LS2 powered MX-5. Cue the car bogging down a little bit, makes his transfer. We have a clutch kick on the top. His smoke back turned on. Wide to the exit of the track. Down to the second place contender of the championship. Down to the initiation, fill up the gears. Fast initiation, wide down to the line. Jumps onto angle, pushes up through the track. Smoke flying up about that side. Back onto the power, turns it on, right through and across the line. The Iceman, Danny Frost himself, here he comes. Pull through the gears. Chucks in on the handbrake, pushes through the center track, quite tight that inside line, but makes his transfer. Keeping a good bit of speed there. Certainly improved from practice, much faster in the middle section. Makes his way tight to the outside. Screamer of a car.
You want to pop?
Here comes Josh Kimberly, he's got a bit of a lead on the line. Break on back. Fast weight transfer. Jumps up. Pulls himself up through the second section of the track. Up top into the final section of clearways. Turns on the smoke there. Absolutely better to throw across the line. Demon round until movements today. Ball making his way to the line. And initiates now. Fast on good angle on the right line. Pushes his way across the track. Wide in. Little wobble in the middle section, but good still. Back onto the power and makes his way down and across the line.
Japanese. We've got paper. Yeah.
Wait, do you?
Thank you.
determined by some possible one of those B-bus. But that